I'm Song Kyung-long guest. Welcome to Asian at Home. And today, I'm going to show you how to make General Tso's chicken or General Tso's chicken, however you call it, General chicken, all right? I got so many requests of this recipe, so today, the recipe's out. Let's get started. First, we are going to prepare our chicken. So I prepared two chicken breasts, boneless and skinless, and I cut it into 1-inch cubes, just like so. And it's about 1 pound of chicken. So if you'd like to use chicken thigh or a mixture of chicken breast and thigh, just go ahead and just use 1 pound of chicken. And in here, we are going to marinate it with 1 teaspoon baking soda, makes chicken really tender and moist, and 1/4 teaspoon of black pepper, 2 teaspoons of Shaoxing wine, Chinese cooking wine. So I just noticed the bowl is a little small. I'm just going to move into the big bowl and just toss them all together. Marinate chicken like so, just set aside right next to you while we are making the sauce, because we are going to make the batter right into the chicken. So for the sauce, you will need 2 tablespoons of sugar, 1 tablespoon of sambal chili garlic sauce, 1 tablespoon of soy sauce, 3 tablespoons of white vinegar. You can use different types of vinegar like a rice vinegar or apple cider vinegar, but I really like this sharp kick from the white vinegar. 2 tablespoons of Shaoxing wine, Chinese cooking wine, 1/4 cup of chicken stock, 1 teaspoon of cornstarch, and whisk everything together until everything is well combined. So the sauce is ready, and before I start getting into the batter with the chicken, I'm going to heat up frying oil in my wok. Filled up my wok about 1 inch deep with frying oil. I'm using a canola oil today, but corn oil, vegetable oil, or peanut oil work really well as well. So heat the oil over medium-high heat. So back to the chicken, I'm going to add 1 egg and 1/4 cup of cornstarch. And the best mixing tool in the kitchen, your hand. Just mix in. All right, we are going to fry up our chicken right away into already heated up oil. Drop the chicken into hot oil very carefully. Depending on your wok size, you have to do 2 or 3 batches. The ideal temperature we are looking for is 300 to 325 degrees. Chicken 4 to 5 minutes, or until chicken is fully cooked and nice and crispy outside. Take the chicken out from the oil to paper towel lined plate. Increase the heat to high heat, and then add all the chicken that we fried. And we are just going to quickly fry just on the outside edge about 1 minute. It's optional, but I'm double frying my chicken just because I want to have this really nicely crispy batter outside, so the batter can handle after we toss in this delicious General Tso's chicken sauce. So my chicken is ready and my sauce is ready to go. All we need for extra flavor for the General Tso's chicken is this chili oil with the chili flakes inside and some more extra dried chilies right here. About 5 to 6 of them is really depending on how much you like. And 4 cloves of garlic that I chopped, roughly chopped. It doesn't have to be fine. All right, everything is ready. All we need to do is just put them all together. In a cold wok, add 2 teaspoons of chili oil, garlic, and dried chilies. Now we are going to heat the wok to medium-high heat. So the chili oil, garlic, everything will slowly warm it up and brings more flavor to this sauce. Stir frequently until you smell this beautiful fragrance from the garlic and the chili, about 1 minute. Then add the sauce. Stir the sauce before you add into the wok, because the cornstarch and the sugar is probably sinked in the bottom. So make sure you add everything into the wok. Keep stirring until the sauce has thickened, about 1 minute or so. Consistency we are looking for is almost like a syrup, thick enough to coat it our chicken. Then add fried chicken right into the sauce. Coat the chicken evenly with the sauce. Then you're done. I'm going to serve right on top of my rice, jasmine rice obviously. I love jasmine rice. Mmm. smoke. If you liked my generoso chicken recipe, give me a thumbs up. And subscribe my channel for more inspirations and ideas of Asian home cooking. Thank you so much for watching me today. And remember, you can always cook Asian food at your house, making it easy and fun. I'm Song Kyung Long Guest, and this right here is Asian at Home. And I will see you next time. Bye! Mwah.